There are those of us that are in this room and out in people that are watching that are carrying around baggage from your past. Things that have happened to you, even maybe as far back as your childhood. And for whatever reason, from time to time, Satan will accuse you and bring up those old sins, and it keeps you from going forward because you're locked in your past. We have so many people that come to the Dallas International Street Church, and when they come in many times all bent over. And if we could look in the spiritual, you know, our battle is truly in the spiritual. We would see people walking in all bent over, being accused of the things that have already happened, that's already gone, and they can't do one thing about. Our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness in high places. I know that tonight that somebody needs to be set free from their past. This woman who had been caught in the very act of adultery. Now, adultery back in those times was a sin as unto death. If you remember in the Ten Commandments, it said, thou shalt not commit adultery. Well, sin is sin, whatever it is. And that sin was punishable by death. But when Jesus came and he went to the cross of Calvary, he says, if you will confess your sins to me, I am faithful to forgive you. Satan's biggest deal is to keep us locked in our past that we cannot go forward. I don't know how many times I've just been sitting around minding my own business, and maybe you can identify with this, and all of a sudden I will think of something that I did that was so horrendous that I've already asked forgiveness and been forgiven, and all of a sudden I take on that guilt and shame. That guilt and shame will kill you. It will keep you locked up and bound. Jesus said, I have come to set the captive free. And tonight he is here to set you free. Whatever it is. You know, we have people that come in that have committed murders. They have spent time in the penitentiary, say 22 years for committing a murder. And they come back and it's still part of their life. If they could only know that by his stripes they were delivered and they were healed, and let that thing go in Jesus' name. He says to cast all of your cares upon him because he cares for you. It is not his will that you keep carrying around that unforgiveness. Hallelujah. Tonight, let's go and let's begin to examine the things that are keeping us bound. What would it be for you? Were you molested, maybe, when you were young by some relative or friend or somebody you didn't even know? And you're walking around and you're thinking as an adult, well, that must have been my fault. It wasn't your fault, man or woman of God. It wasn't your fault. A lot of times we blame, we hate. Things keep us bound up in hatred and anger and unbelief. And we ask ourselves, you know, if God was real, why would he let that happen to me? But many times the Bible says what the devil has meant for evil, God will turn for good. He's working all things together for your good, brothers and sisters, because you love him and you're called according to his purpose. You know, tonight, there are some that may have been raped. And you wonder, you know, why did that happen? And you're still hating that person. You know, that person may be dead and gone. That person is not even in existence anymore. It's only hurting you. You know, the Bible says that we must get rid of those things, lest a root of bitterness will set in our hearts and defile our temple. Tonight you can be free because Jesus Christ went to the cross and you have all authority over the enemy. You can be free tonight. He says, you know, just let those things go. We begin to take authority over the enemy. You know, we have power over our thoughts. He says, take every thought into captivity and put it under the blood of Jesus Christ. You know, unforgiveness will kill you. You know, tonight, just think with me of somebody that may have hurt you so deeply and you just can't get over it. You know, just this week we had a young man come into our church and he was so tormented He and his father had had a huge battle. And he came in with hatred and anger and murder in his heart. Many times we harbor those thoughts and it begins to tear us apart. And you know, he just almost exploded, but he took his anger by going out and getting high. You don't have to do that. You can give those thoughts and those things to the Lord. This woman that was almost stoned and killed by the Pharisees, you know, don't you know that as she walked away, she could hardly believe that Jesus Christ himself had come up and said, "You are forgiven. Go and sin no more." Once you've been forgiven, your sins are thrown into the sea of forgiveness. Forgetfulness, never to be brought up again. The only people that bring them up is you and the devil. We know that Satan is an accuser of the brethren. He wants to keep you bound, but tonight I want you to know that if you have been set free in the Son Jesus Christ, you have been set free. Set free. Hallelujah. Tonight I want to ask you, do you want to be set free? Do you want to be set free from your past? Do you want to be set free from what's going on with you and with sin in the present? He says, if you will come to me, he said, call upon me and I will answer you. And I will show you great and mighty things that you did not know. Isaiah 1:18, come, let us reason together. For your sins be as scarlet, I have made them white as snow. Whatever you need from him tonight, he says in 1 Peter 2:23 and 24, by my stripes you were healed. By my stripes you were delivered. What do you need tonight? As our choir comes to sing Amazing Grace, what do you need? His grace is sufficient. Like the woman with the issue of blood, you know, she reached out and she touched him. And she knew that if she could touch him and just touch his garment, she would be healed. Tonight, by faith, reach out wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Just reach out and say, Jesus, touch me. Touch me, Jesus. Jesus, set me free. I speak to addictions right now. I command them to be broken in Jesus' name. That addiction to crack cocaine and heroin, marijuana, cigarettes, pornography, I break your power right now in the name of Jesus. Satan, I take total authority over you. You've been tormenting somebody out there too long, and you are finished right now by the blood of Jesus Christ. If you can only realize who you are in Christ Jesus, you have all power and all authority over the enemy. Take authority tonight and recognize who you are in Christ Jesus. He said, I give you all power and all authority to walk on scorpions and snakes and drink any poisonous things, and it won't hurt you. The devil's biggest trick is to keep you from knowing who you are in Christ Jesus. You have all power, all authority, all power. Tonight, reach out and take it. Whatever you need from him. Don't be bound anymore. Let those things go. Let all that resentment, let all that anger, let that murderous spirit go. Let that get even spirit go. Just get even with somebody that's hurt you. The Bible says God will not be mocked. Whatsoever someone has done to you, whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. Right now, if you in faith will just begin to reach out. Just reach out, just right where you are. Just begin right now, just close your eyes. And just begin to think upon Jesus. Just begin to think upon him as he walked down that Calvary road. As he went to the cross and he shed his holy blood. One drop of his blood set you free and healed you. The devil made his biggest mistake when he crucified our Savior. And that holy blood began to flow from Calvary's side and began to wash away our sins. His amazing grace tonight is all we need, brothers and sisters.